In this problem, we charge a tank with 4.5 kilograms of propane at 25 degrees C, and we're given the tank dimensions. And what we want to do is use the SRK equation state to calculate what's the pressure in the tank. So first we should draw a simple diagram of the system and write down the information that we know. And then we also should look up some of the information that we need. For the equation of state, we're going to need critical pressure, critical temperature, eccentric factor, and the molecular weight so we can calculate the volume per mole. Let me write that information down, so I'll pause while I do that. So the first thing I'm going to do is calculate how many moles. The number of moles is going to be the weight divided by the molecular weight, so 4.5 kilograms is 4,500 grams, and the molecular weight 44.09 grams per mole. So the number of moles in the tank is 102.06. Next, then we want to calculate the volume. Right? We want the volume per mole. We have the temperature. We're trying to determine the pressure. So the first to calculate the volume per mole, we need the volume of the tank. It's a cylinder, so the total volume is pi diameter squared over 4 times the length of the tank. So let me substitute numbers into this calculation. So now I have the volume of the tank, I can calculate the specific volume, the volume per mole, the total volume of the tank divided by the number of moles in the tank. So let me substitute those numbers in. So now I'm ready to use the SRK equation of state. And what that equation of state says, it says the pressure is equal to gas constant times absolute temperature over the volume per mole minus a constant, and then multiplied by two other constants and divided by volume per mole, and then a volume per mole again plus this constant B. We have three constants that we have to calculate. These are related to the critical pressure and the critical temperature, the eccentric factor. Let me write down, I'm just looking them up in a reference for the SRK equation of state. So here are the constants in terms of critical temperature and critical pressure, values that we looked up, and the eccentric factor. Now I'm going to just substitute values in, and so I'll just write the numbers down, and then we can look at the results of these calculations. So I've calculated the values for A and B. The units have to be consistent. We plug back into the SRK equation. To calculate alpha, I'm going to do this in a couple steps. I'm going to call this value here M, and then let me substitute the values in. So I calculated M and I substitute in, and I have a value of alpha, and should point out that this is dimensionless. And so now we have the parameters to substitute back into the SRK equation of state. So notice that here we substitute reduced temperature. So that's the temperature divided by the critical temperature. Now that we have all the parameters, we can substitute into the SRK equation state. So let me rewrite the equation and substitute in the values. So the units check, and we end up with units in megapascals. And so we would conclude the pressure in the tank of propane is 1.78 megapascals or 1.8 megapascals. But we have to be careful. We're dealing with a cubic equation of state, and so one thing we should check is, at 25 degrees C, what's the saturation pressure of propane? And if we look that up, use an Antoine's equation, or look it up in the literature, we find that it's 0.937 megapascals, which is less than 1.785 megapascals. Well, we're not going to have a pressure greater than the saturation pressure at this condition, unless we have a liquid present. But it turns out liquid volume is much smaller. So what's happening is that we're we looked at a pressure volume diagram and we have some cubic equation of state. And so here's saturation conditions. And basically we substitute in the value for volume and we calculate the pressure here. Right, this is the pressure, 1.785 megapascals. This isotherm is for 25 degrees C. So this pressure, saturation pressure, 0.937 megapascals. So we calculate a value, but it doesn't correspond to a physically meaningful value. Remember, this region and this region do not correspond to physically meaningful values. And instead, we have vapor-liquid equilibrium. And so the equation that we in the curve that we want is that one. And so we've calculated a value that's not on this curve. And instead, at this volume, we're going to be here. So we're going to have a vapor-liquid mixture in equilibrium. And we could calculate how much of vapor and how much liquid. So then our final answer to the problem is that we're at 0.94 megapascals, which is the same as 9.4 bar. So we have to be careful in interpreting these cubic equations of state to make sure we're looking at the correct condition.